Hello everybody, in this year I'm going to do the mid-year book freakout tag for 2020. It is a bit late, but you know, better late than never. I didn't have the time to film it before this, and I really wanted to do it since I didn't do this tag last year. Because last year I was also late, but like so late that it was embarrassing to still do the tag. But this time around, I'm going to do it. I'm going to do the mid-year book freakout tag. In case you don't know, but I feel like most people will know, because like this is one of the most popular tags on BookTube and everybody does it. But in case you don't know, it's a tag with questions all about what you've read so far this year and what you thought of them and like your favorite book, your least favorite book, all those kinds of things. So yeah, that is pretty straightforward, just answering questions about books that I've read so far. So I'm just going to start with the video and tell you all about, or like do the mid-year book freakout tag. I'm going to do it. Question number one, the best book you've read so far in 2020. I've read some pretty amazing books in 2020 so far. Most of them I read at the beginning of the year, but still, there are quite a few. But the one that I'm going to have to choose is Where the Crawdads Sing by Delia Owens. This book is about a young girl named Kaya who grows up on her own in the so-called marsh in the 1950s and 1960s in a small town in North Carolina, and she is considered very weird and she doesn't really belong with the other people. She's very much on her own, but she's also very much into nature and she loves to live in the marsh and the swamp and the water and all the creatures there. But then at the beginning of the book you are told that there's this guy named Chase Andrews who is found dead, and Kaya becomes a suspect of murder. So this book is so many things at once. It is a growing up story. It is about this girl. It is so beautiful. It's very much about loneliness and not fitting in, but it's also about love. And then there's also this whole murder investigation, and it's just, there is so much to it. I will say though, the murder investigation part is my least favorite part, but still, I think it's done really well. I just love that this book has everything. It has the best atmosphere, the best world building. You really feel like you're there in the marsh. And I just love Kaya's story so much. I could not put it down. It was wonderful, and it's definitely my favorite book of the year so far. Question number two, the best sequel you've read in 2020. And for this, I have like two books of the same series because I couldn't really choose between them, but that is The Girl in the Tower and The Winter of the Witch, which are books 2 and 3 in the Bear and the Nightingale series, or the Winter Night Trilogy as it's called. Also a series that I really, really loved. I read the entirety of it this year. The main character is a girl named Vasya who's always been very different, and it is in this sort of medieval version of Russia. It is very much inspired by Russian folklore, and there's so much going on, and Vasya is one of the few who can see all these spirits and demons and everything, and it's just magical and wonderful, and it's very much winter-like, so I read it at the beginning of the year. It is hard to give a precise plot for this book because it's so all over the place and it's so hard to really explain. You really have to experience for yourself. But I really loved it. It was beautiful. Like, the writing is just gorgeous, and again, I really, really love this series, and I really love that the second and the third book were also very good, just as the first one was. I can definitely recommend this series because it was amazing, and it's a reason, like there's a reason I have finished it so soon, because normally I don't really finish book series that soon, but this one I read entirely in like 2 months or so. It was beautiful. So definitely best sequels or like third books of a series that I've read this year. Question number three, a new release that you haven't read yet but that you want to read. Okay, so do you have a minute? Because there are so many. I've been not keeping up with my new releases of the year. I still have The King of Crows by Libba Bray that I've been talking about since the beginning of the year. Still haven't read that one yet. I have The Glass Hotel by Emily St. John Mendel that I want to read. Like, there are so many, but the one I'm going to choose for this question is My Calamity Jane by Cynthia Hand, Brody Ashton, and Jodi Meadows. This is the third and I think final book in the sort of collection of Lady Janie's books. I won't really call it a book series because the stories don't really have anything to do with each other. But the thing that they have in common is that these books tell a story about a famous Jane, and they retell it and they make it really funny and really silly, and it's just the best thing ever. The first book, My Lady Jane, was about Jane Grey, which is like one of my favorite books. I love it so much. It always makes me happy. The second one was My Plain Jane, which was about Jane Eyre. And this is My Calamity Jane, and it's about Calamity Jane, who To be honest, I don't really know because I believe she's sort of like a Western figure from like American history, like an outlaw or something. Really don't know much about her, basically nothing, because that's just not my expertise with history. So I do need to like read up just like basic facts about her life. But in any case, I think this one is again going to be like really silly and really funny again, because that's just the case with these books, and there's always some supernatural element to it. And I believe in this book it's werewolves, in the other ones it was like shape-shifting and ghosts. So there's like always something weird and supernatural about them, but that is also something that makes it funny. Really need to read this one soon because it has come out, when was it, the beginning of the month? Not too long ago. Like, it's not like it has been on my shelves for ages, but I do really want to read it, and that's going to happen soon. Like, I don't know when, but soon. Question number four, the most anticipated release for the second half of the year. For this, I have a book that might not be very interesting for most of you guys because it's a Dutch book by a Dutch author, but it's called Zondagsleven by Judith Visser. It's the sequel to a book that she has written that is called Zondagskind. Zondagskind means Sunday's child, Zondagsleven means Sunday's life. It makes more sense in Dutch. But these books are inspired by the author's own life, Judith Visser's own life, because it's about, the first one is about a girl who grows up with autism, but she doesn't really know it, and nobody in her surroundings knows that she has it and knows about it. So the first book is about her feeling very out of place and very weird, and she doesn't understand why she's always sort of different than other people, why certain things are harder for her. And it is wonderfully written, it's from her point of view, and it's exactly like based on the author's own life. Now the second book, Zondagsleven, is about her as an adult. So now that she knows that she has autism, there are certain things she can do to improve her life and make it easier. But also there are still a lot of hardships to come, and again, it's based on the author's own life, but her adult life. So I love the first book so much, so I cannot wait for the second book. It's coming out in either September or October, something along those lines, at least in the fall of this year. In any case, I'm so excited and I'm going to read it immediately when I have it in my hands. And I am so sad that there's not an English translation because I want everybody to read it. There is a German translation of the first book, so if you're German speaking, then you can also read it. I would very much recommend it. It's amazing. Question number five, the biggest disappointment of the year. For this, I have to go with A Good Girl's Guide to Murder by Holly Jackson, because this book, it was so hyped up and I had such high expectations, but it was very boring to me. A Good Girl's Guide to Murder is about a young girl named Pip, and like 5 years ago, a girl was murdered or like missing in her town, and another boy was found guilty of that murder, but she doesn't think that he's guilty. So for her school project, she's going to research this murder and she wants to find out and like prove that that boy was not guilty, if that makes sense. So she's basically doing a murder investigation on her own. The premise, very cute, and of course young adult, sort of murder mysteries, you don't see that often. The beginning was sort of interesting, but after a while it became very boring, and also sometimes I had a lot of trouble like actually sympathizing with Pip as a main character, because there was definitely a lot of cases of decision making that is just like, Why would you do that? That's just stupid. But yeah, I think I personally didn't really connect with this story. It didn't do it for me. It put me almost in a reading slump. It took me ages to finish it. It was just boring to me. Really not my kind of book. It wasn't like actively bad. In the end, I gave it like 3 stars, but I think it's more like 2.5 out of 5 stars. It was just okay, but really not the book that I was hoping for. So yeah, quite a disappointment. Question number 6 is the biggest surprise of the year. For this, I have Educated by Tara Westover. This is a non-fiction book and it's about Tara's own life. She grew up very isolated with her family, like far away from society and with their own rules and without electricity and everything. She never went to school, she never went to see a doctor. They have their own IDs, or at least their her father has. But then when she's older, she goes to university and it turns out that she's pretty smart, and it's about her struggles and her life and everything. And of course I was hoping to like it, because otherwise I wouldn't have picked it up, but I was so pleasantly surprised with how well it was written. And I love the story, and even though it's nonfiction, it didn't feel like that. It was just so interesting and so, again, well written, and I could not put it down. I just flew through it. It was an amazing story, and it is so weird to think that this has actually happened, because there are so many like mind-blowing things, and it's interesting to see how her life was so different, and she didn't have a lot of things that are normal to most people. Like, I don't know, it's hard to explain, but I really loved it and I thought it was amazing. So definitely a very pleasant surprise. Question number 7 is a new favorite author. It can be a debut author or just an author that is new to you. I'm going to have to go with Catherine Arden from the Winter Night trilogy again, because I love the series so much. I can talk about how much I love the series for ages, but I'm not going to do that. I really love the series and I definitely want to read what else she has written. I believe she has middle grade-ish books. Not sure. I have to take like a look into that, but overall very pleasantly surprised with her writing and her books. And then question number 8 is newest fictional crush, and I'm still going to have to stay with the Winter Night trilogy. And I'm going to have to choose like the Winter King, who is a character in this series. Also called Morosko. I'm probably not pronouncing that correctly, I'm sorry. But that character was definitely... that was something. So I would say definitely like a fictional crush. I don't have that many fictional crushes, but I feel like that one was just... yeah, he was a very interesting character in that way. I hope that makes sense. Question number 9 is newest favorite character, just in general. Again, I have to go back to a book that I've already talked about. And the favorite character is Kaya from Where the Crawdads Sing, because as I mentioned before, I just love her so much. The entire book around, I just wanted to like sort of go into the book and give her a hug, and oh, she was so sweet and so cute, and I felt so sad for her when certain things happened. I loved her. I just think that such a main character is very important to me if I want to really love a book, because she was definitely one of the things, like the main thing that made this book so amazing. And I'm so happy that I read it and still love it so much. Question number 10, a book that made you cry. That is exactly none, because I don't cry at books. I never cry at books. Like, the books that have made me cry are like The Nightingale by Kristen Hannah. That's pretty much it. But I'm going to choose like a book that was like that sort of made me sad. It was sad in general, and that is Silka's Journey by Heather Morris. This is sort of the sequel to The Tattooist of Auschwitz, and it follows a girl named Silka who after the concentration camps goes to another camp in Russia, and it's about her life there, and it's all based on her true story, because this was a actual woman that lived, even though there are liberties taken with her story. And it's not a very upbeat story. There are definitely some instances where I felt very sad for her, because of course the circumstances and everything that was happening. I thought it was very, very well written. I loved it even more than The Tattooist of Auschwitz. I don't know, this story just spoke to me a bit more, because I know people are going to ask, you can read Silka's Journey without having read The Tattooist of Auschwitz. It just gives a bit more of a background, background information if you read that one, but you don't have to read it to understand Silka's Journey, because it's its own story. Question number 11, a book that made you happy. That is definitely A Pinch of Magic by Michelle Harrison. I read this for Believe It On, which is a read-it-on organized by Gavin, all about reading middle grade books. This is also a middle grade book, and it's also, I believe, one of Gavin's favorite books. He loves it so much, so I just had to pick it up. A Pinch of Magic is about three sisters who are trapped in a curse, and during this book they're trying to break the curse, and there's like so much more, and it's so cute, so sweet, so amazing. It really made me very happy. Such an amazing middle grade book. I really need to read more middle grade, and if there's another round of Believe It On, I'm definitely going to participate. I believe there's going to be one later this year, not sure. But yeah, I'm very happy that I picked it up, because this book made me so happy. It was just, oh, so cute. Like, amazing. I really need to read the sequel as soon as possible. I've been putting it off for so long. I need to read the sequel. Question number 12, most beautiful book you've bought this year or received. For this, I have chosen my new editions of the Harry M series by Suzanne Collins. These are just gorgeous, and they are the 10th anniversary editions. So we have The Hunger Games, and then they're not in order. We have The Hunger Games, Catching Fire, and then Mockingjay, and they are just gorgeous. I love them so much. I really prefer them to the original covers, and they're amazing. I will leave links to them down below in the description box, because people are always asking where I've bought them, and I bought them on Amazon, but you can also buy them on Book Depository. So gorgeous. I love them so much. I love this book series so much. It is amazing. And then question number 13, what books do you need to read by the end of the year? Well, many, many, many books. I mean, My Calamity Jane, and like so many, like the sequel to A Pinch of Magic, A Sprinkle of Sorcery, like, oh, so many. The list is endless. But the one that I've chosen for this question, I've just chosen one because otherwise this video is going to be hours long. But that is Lilac Girls by Marta Hall Kelly. So this book I received in a book haul swap that I did with Leonie from the Book Leo. She chose this one for me because I really love historical fiction, and this one has been said to be very like good for people who like The Nightingale by Kristen Hannah, which is one of my favorite books. So Leonie has chosen very wisely with this one. But that is also why I need to read it. And the story of the book is maybe also interesting. It's also about, it's based on the real life story of some survivors of concentration camps, some female survivors of World War II. And what is the camp called? The camp is called Ravensbrück, the notorious Nazi camp for women. So it's about that and about survivors of that. Don't know much about the story apart from that sort of premise. But I know I'll love it because I will always love books that are historical fiction and about World War II. And yeah, I just know I will love it. Really need to read it because I want to know how good this one is going to be. And yeah, that was it for the mid-year book Freakout Tag. I finally done it. Even though it's a bit late, it's still here. So happy to be doing book tags again. And I'm very excited for the second half of the year. I think it's going to be a very good second half. And with like lots of amazing books that I finally have time to read now that school is like a bit less stressful. And yeah, I really hope you enjoyed this video. And if you did, maybe go subscribe, give it a thumbs up, share, leave a comment, whatever. If you want to, of course, you don't have to. But if you want to, it would always really help my channel. And then hopefully I will see you again very soon in one of my next videos. Bye!